I'm obsessed at the rate at which African fashion keeps growing the whole time. And I'm up for all these designers doing incredible things to promote African fashion. We have the queen of fashion in Uganda. She's ruling the airwaves of fashion when it comes to everything to do with, you know, the red carpet and everything else. She has showcased at Accra Ghana Fashion Week, and she's going to be waving the Ugandan flag higher at the UNA causes in Washington, D.C. I am obsessed with this girl. This lady, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Urban Fashionista. My name is Joam, and I'll be talking to the queen of fashion. Fatuma Asha, hi, how are you?
Hi, Joram, how are you?
Very well, thank you. I love what you do. So I would love to know, how did it all start, Fatuma Asha? Because I know the Urban Fashionistas watching right now have this whole thing of, you know, she came from nowhere and out of the blue, she's ruling.
People got to know about me like 3 years ago because I wasn't advertising myself enough. I wasn't on social media, so I have a group of friends that forced me to join social media. That's why I've been booming for at least 3 years. But I've been in the industry for over 10 years.
Hold up, 10 years? What were you doing in all those 10 years?
I was just hiding somewhere. Hiding. You know, you cannot be known until you're on social media these days. The only way you can get known is joining it. People cannot know about you.
How did it start? I'm curious to know.
Of course, I loved playing with dolls growing up. I used to alter people's clothes. You never could leave a shirt anywhere. I could cut it, make shirts out of it. I could cut my grandma's gomeses and make dresses out of them, alter my shorts, alter my dresses and turn them into something else. I could do that when I was little. But I went to school for fashion as well. At the university, I first did human resource. Then after like a semester, I had to change. My father didn't even know about it. I switched courses.
Why? Because of the passion? Or?
I felt it wasn't my calling, but my dad couldn't believe, like, you have to go to school to be a designer. I think he confused it with being a tailor. He would just go like, a lot of people here are tailors and they don't go to school for it. Why would you want to waste my money like that? Just go and do something else. So I did human resource for him, not for me.
Cut you short, to all the parents out there that keep forcing, you know, the teenagers, people out there that want to pursue their dreams, Gwenom Gamba, oh, you must be a doctor, you must do this. Learn from Fatuma Asha. So you're done with fashion school and then you get into the jungle. How has it been for you getting to the top?
It hasn't been easy. It's never easy, and the competition is really tight. Though I don't think it has to be negative competition. It should be like a competition that builds us, not a competition that tears us apart. Yeah, but it hasn't been easy. We can all fit at the top. I believe that we can all fit at the top.
And by the way, she only dresses up women, honestly, Fatuma, eh?
Don't have money, you know that.
You need to dress up people like us.
I'm not sure, maybe in the future, but I don't find anything fascinating about guys where it's just boring. It's just one thing that is halted a little. Maybe they change a button, put a hole here, and then they think they've changed the whole thing. No.
Tell us more about the fashion school.
The school started this year. It has always been my dream to do a fashion school. To tell you the truth, my dream wasn't being a famous designer. I wanted to be a fashion teacher. That has always been my dream, because I used to talk about it. I remember one time during campus time, I have a friend, she is also a designer. She tells me about opening up a big store, of being in fashion shows, doing bride and groom, and I keep telling her, you know what, my dream is opening up a fashion school. But it's not easy opening up a fashion school. It's really, really expensive than people think. It costs a lot of money. So that's why it took so long to open it. But I'm looking forward to giving my knowledge to people that really want it, because a lot of people don't want it. And I want to produce designers that know what they are doing, instead of these designers that are just fumbling with things, doing wrong measurements. Sometimes you have to go to school to learn those things. It doesn't come natural to everyone.
Amazing. And then I've been looking around your store. I've seen you dress up all these celebrities. The Urban Fashionistas, this lady has dressed up literally everyone in town. I don't want to name all the celebrities, but everyone. Do you just target celebrities, or you even work with normal people like us, Fatuma?
I love working with normal people, and I don't target celebrities, they target me. That's what people don't understand. Yes. The average person, the everyday person, those people have money. And I love money. So I take all my clients very seriously. I don't have to to look at only celebrities to dress. It's good to dress celebrities because they put your name up there. But when it comes to making money, these people have money and they deserve the respect.
What do you usually go for? Because I see you working with Les a lot. You work with, you know, African prints. You're very unpredictable. What is your niche like? What do you usually go for?
I usually get inspiration from fabric. Like I told you some time back, I'm not the kind of designer that will lie to you that I get inspired by nature.
What?
No.
Everything inspires you?
Everything inspires me, especially fabric. I look at a fabric and I get ideas of what to do with it. I look at a print. I love prints, but I love everything. I'll look at a fabric and then I will not even sleep. I just want to go and do things to it. That's why I have different things. I don't stick to one thing. I can be in two arms, then I do arms for 6 months, then I get over arms and I do collars. I be doing collars for 6 months or 3 months, then I get over them and I just do something else. Yeah.
And now that you're doing very well, I know there's so many copycats out there. So many copycats, like they're going to see something and they'll just copy and paste it. How do you deal with this? Because you're a fashion designer, which sets you apart from the tailors. But how do you deal with copycats in the fashion industry?
Sometimes it hurts. I will not lie.
It can. Honest truth.
It hurts when someone copies something that took you months to think about, and then they are duplicating it exactly the way it is to make money out of it. But I would not mind if someone copies my design and twists it. You know, in fashion, when you twist a design, it's no longer yours. It's someone else's. That's their own design. They've twisted it. Maybe they just used you as an inspiration. So I would prefer someone to use me as an inspiration. Do not produce it the way I've produced it. And when you get a client that shows you something and they tell you, I want it exactly like that, I find out of twisting it. I'll tell you, let's twist it. Let's change it to suit your body, not to copy it the way it is.
And then speaking of which, you just talked about body types. To the urban fashionistas watching right now, they want to get knowledge about body types because I've seen so many beautiful, curvy women. Some of them have, I'm not going to call them awkward shapes because women have different shapes altogether. Exactly, there's no awkward shape. There's no awkward shape, yes. So to the ladies that are watching right now, school them about shapes and how to dress up for shapes. Because most women do make mistakes. They'll see a gown that looks very good on Helen Lukoma and they'll be like, I am going to wear that gown. And before you know it, fashion disaster.
What I know about shapes, if you want to hide a particular something you're insecure about, don't put a bright, bold color. If you're insecure about your bust, wear dark colors. If you're insecure about your hip area, like you have very huge hips, still wear dark colors around there. And the body that wears almost everything is the triangle body. That straight body that people call figure one. Those ones can wear anything. Thank you. That's why most models are tall and short and straight. Those, if you're straight and short, and tall and lean, you can wear anything you want. But if you're curvy, be very careful about the colors you wear. Stay away from bold colors if you're hiding something.
How do you deal with very complicated clients that will walk in and say, Fatuma, this is it. And before you know it, your images are on fresh pictures with these women killing you.
Actually, that is still a problem. I have this thing I do, I'm kind of big-headed. So you tell me, do this for me, I'm like, it will not suit you, please, let's do this. And you can't tell a client your body is bad. There is no body that is bad. Just do something for them that suits their body. So I have this thing of, if I make you something and you don't like it, I always bring it to my store to sell it. So if you tell me to do something and I twist it and I do something that is going to suit you and that I think is going to suit you better and you fit it, most of the time it works for me. When they wear it and it's different from what they told me to do and it suits them, they just go like, oh, it's even better, it looks better, this is better. And if they don't like it, I just go like, let me go and do exactly what you want. So I get this and take it to the and bring it to the store.
So you've been doing all these fashion weeks in Ghana, you're traveling the world. Tell us some of your experiences at Accra Fashion Week.
Accra was amazing. I think it was the best so far. They were so organized. I've never been at a show that was that organized. And I met incredible friends. I met incredible people. I would say Ghanaians are very, very friendly. I ate a lot of food I've never tasted before. I love foreign food. I love eating things I've not eaten before.
it comes to, you know, Western, West Africa, there's a lot of kitenge, there's a lot of African fabric. And then when you come back home here, everything is very subtle. How would you compare their industry with ours?
West Africans are very, very loyal. And first, the African print, what we call African print, wasn't theirs. Mm. You know the history of African print. They just adopted it and owned it. Mm. They owned it, they grabbed it, and it, no one else can take it. It's just theirs. When you wear an African print, people know you're from West Africa. Mm. That's how loyal they are. Unlike here, people here are not loyal. They'll support you, and they're not supporting you. Yeah, but West Africans are loyal, I would say that. And I think that's what makes them different.
Fatuma has stood out so much that she's been winning awards a lot. I will let her tell us the awards that she has won. Otherwise, Mujagamajam naya wana nyo. But you know, she has won so many awards. So we will get to the awards, and you know, you'll tell us some of the awards that you've won. And how do you advise the upcoming fashion designers to be like you?
I've been nominated several times, and I won Puffer. I won Puffer. It was, I think, the competition was so tight. Anita was there, and I respect Anita very, very much. She's amazing as a designer. She's amazing as a person. I thought she was going to take it. Then all of a sudden, they read my name. I was shocked. I even had a piece of chicken in my hands that just took off like, woo!
Would you one day wake up and say, oh, my brand, Fatuma Asha, is going to say, collaborate with Anita Beryl, and we're going to put up something major?
I think it will be amazing. It will be really, really amazing. The only thing with Ugandans, when they start something, they're just looking at the profits. Profits, profits, profits. They want profits before they even inject any money in it.
America already loves this girl. Should we expect you to do New York Fashion Week?
Did I tell you I got an invitation for New York Fashion Week?
Tell them.
This year. But I didn't go.
Oh,
I didn't
God.
Go because of different things, funds inclusive. And funny thing, when I went to West Africa, a lot of these designers that showcased in Accra Fashion Week, their governments support them. But here, you cannot be supported. And I was shocked when you come back at the airport, they want to tax you. I'm from representing my country. Why do you want to tax me for something I've not sold? Why? I cried when they told me they want to tax me. I'm supporting myself, everything to go and represent my country, and you want to tax me. So I didn't do New York Fashion Week because of that.
Your work looks very legit. You know, there's somewhere else you shop from.
I buy a lot of my fabrics here, but I just have an eye for fabric. I can look at a lot of it and I don't get confused. I never get confused. Unless a lot of it is nice, like the whole of it is nice, that's when I get confused.
So Fatuma, before I let you go, I'm going to put you on the spotlight right there in the camera. Your top five style tips as a fashion designer.
Top five style tips. Lipstick, one, compulsory for every woman. Drink water so that you have a beautiful skin. You don't have to wear makeup all the time, just have a beautiful skin. What else? Belt. Get a belt. It's an accessory. Get high heels. A bad outfit can be saved by high heels. What else? I don't have the favorite one. I have four. Those four.
Okay, thank you so much, Fatuma Asha. You've been amazing. I've learned so much from you. And I can't wait to see you, you know, rule the world, because I see a potential designer that is going to, you know, take the whole world by storm. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Fatuma Asha, the creative director, the CEO for Fatuma Asha. She's a makeup artist, by the way, as well. She does that as her side hustle, eh? But the main job is her being a fashion designer. I've had a lot of fun talking to her, and I hope you've learned something from her. My name is Joram, and keep watching The Urban Fashionista.